Good morning and God bless you. I'm reading from Genesis chapter 3 verse number 6 in the New King James Version. So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree desirable to make one wise, she took of it of its fruit and ate. She also gave to her husband with her, and he ate. That incident of the scripture I just read now was where the whole world missed it in Adam and also in Eve. And the trick of the devil has not changed. So I'd like us to go back to the story in Genesis. How did the devil succeed in collecting humanity authority from Adam and Eve, our first father and first mother? Number one, he asked Eve, "Are you really sure God has said you shouldn't eat of this tree? Are you really sure God said you shouldn't commit fornication or adultery? Are you sure God said you should drink alcohol or not? Are you sure the Lord is asking you to lie or not?" So there was a doubt suggested to Eve. But the doubt was not powerful enough to make Eve fall. Whatever the devil suggested is not as important. He could suggest anything. He had suggested before then and nothing happened. But here, something happened. The covenant that God had with man became broken by one single action. And that is what this scripture we are looking at today. Number one, the woman saw that the tree was good for food. So until the woman saw, there was no temptation. I've started speaking on this lust of eyes, learn to notice and stir. And some people are still joking. They don't know the weight of such action in Christendom. That what you see is very important to how much of the righteousness inside that you bring outside. Here, all you need to do is to see. You have to be careful what you look at. Otherwise, what you look at eventually become what you look like. Very important. Look at it. The woman saw that the tree was good for food, that the girl was good to be laid with, that the man was good to be taken, that the money was good to be stolen. He saw. So the first major trick of the devil is what you see. And that's why the new beginning God is introducing to the old world can only begin by being careful what you see. Now, I want you to see what happened immediately. She saw. The next thing that happened is that she saw that it was pleasant to the eyes. There are a lot of things that are pleasant to the eyes, but they are not good for you. This was the only thing that took life out of us, and Satan gained the throne of humanity until Jesus came to remove it. Look at it. It was pleasant to the eyes. There are a lot of things that will be pleasant to look at, but the end is going to be destruction. And then the tree is desirable to make one wise. So when you see, you will see pleasant thing to your flesh, and then your desire will rise up. The devil has not changed his tactics. His device has been one from the beginning. Look at it. He said it was desirable to make one wise. So because he has seen, she has sinned, and because she is already pleasant to her feeling, she desired. And because she desired, the Bible said she took of his fruit and ate it. So everything you see and you think is pleasant and it gives birth to desire in you, without any reservation, you're going to take it and eat. And the moment it happened, we lost the control of the world to Satan. You're going to lose control of your life to greed, to fornication, to immorality, to pollution. You will allow the devil to gain access to the throne of your life if you're not going to begin to check what you see, what you think is pleasant, what you desire, and then what you take and eat. And in fact, the bad thing is this. The Bible concluded that scripture by saying she also gave it to her husband. You will be surprised how many people have been infected with the virus of immorality simply because someone saw and then he thought it was a pleasant thing and he desired it and she ate or he ate it and brought it to you. So influence is going to be cursed. Even not only you will you bring down, you will bring the people around you down. God forbid. So what should you do? I want us to go back to what Jesus recommended as the major way to conquer what you see in life. In Matthew chapter 18, verse number 9, the TPT version, the scripture says, "And if your eyes is always focusing on sin, pluck it out and throw it away. For it is better for you to enter into heaven with one eye than to be thrown into hell fire with two." Many pastors and many of the believers don't want to hear anything about hellfire. They say, "How can you, a pastor, be talking about hellfire?" No, no. Here is Jesus talking about it. Hellfire. Now, he began by saying, your eyes must be trained. Perspective is everything. You enter into a supermarket, you are careful about what you look at. You go into the beach, you are careful about what you look at. Not even about immorality, but about all kinds of greed that has entered into the world, the worldly kind of sense. If echo is passing and you are thinking you must get it, and because of that, you begin to do everything, including things that does not please God, to get money, because you just saw something, you think it's pleasant, and you desire it, and you want to go after it at all costs, if it will mean going into crime. Look at it. He said, you have to train your eyes, perspective. Number two, focusing on sin. You have to be careful not to focus. We're talking about staring. So here Jesus is saying, if your eyes is always focusing on sins, always saying wrong things, what did he say? You pluck it out. Wow. How can Jesus ask us to pluck our eyes out? That's an hyperbole. Talking about the Father, you have to sacrifice some basic thing in order for you to get to the kingdom of heaven. He said, number one, pluck it out. Number two, throw it away. You may have to stop. Some of you may have to even stop using phone for some time, going online, because it's not helping you. Pluck it out. Take a hard decision. Be hard on yourself. Cut off from the series of that movie that is always getting you high. You have to cut off with some friends. They are beneficial in the flesh, but you don't want them anymore. You stop talking to that lady. You stop talking to that guy. You stop chatting in the night. You stop doing the late night call. Pluck it out. That's what the scripture says. Pluck it out and throw it away. And then he said, it is better to be one high heaven candidate than to have two highs and you go to hell. Hell is real. I want you to look at the way Matthew chapter 5, verse number 29 put it. It was verse number 28 we read on Monday. But I want you to see what happened when the Bible said, if you look at a woman seductively, you have committed adultery. Look at what he said in verse 29. If your right eye seduces you to fall into sin, then go blind in your right eyes. For you are better off losing sight in one eye than to have your whole body thrown into hell fire. Exactly the same thing Jesus is talking about. Hell. There is hell. There is heaven, I agree. Most of you believe in it. But here Jesus is talking about hell. What will take you to hell? Number one, eye seduction. You look at people or you look at things with a wrong desire for lust. Look at it. You fall into sin because of eye seduction. The only thing God recommends is you go blind. Go blind to those things. Close your eyes to them. Close your eyes and stop looking at things that is going to get you polluted and dirty. I see you making heaven. You will not go to hell in Jesus' name. I want you to write under here, I am heaven's candidate. I will not go to hell. God bless you.